Hello again, loyal subjects. It is I, your glorious emperor. Finally getting back to continuing what I started with Empire Total War. Yeah, sorry about the wait. It's just, it's not exactly easy to make videos when you're at boarding school, if you get my drift. I'm never going to say that again. Drift is an awful word. Right. Okie dokie. So this was my territory. Last time we saw it. Over here, we took the territory of Christiania at great cost due to some rather bad deployment on my part. Gotta be replenishing for a while. But for now, the fleet guards the straits, so the Danes aren't going to be putting any troops over into my borders for a while, which is all good and dandy. I believe I was recruiting an artillery piece. Yes, yes. I think everything is in order, but it looks like there's a whole bunch of Russians under a guy called Ivan. Ha! What an original name for a Russian who's advancing upon St. Petersburg. Yay, and it looks like he's going to get there before Adam is. Which is a real pity. But oh well, I can easily get it back. I can just siege it. Yeah. So we're probably going to lose St. Petersburg next turn. Not much I can do about it. So, let's see the disaster unfold. I knew it. I knew they were going to attack. But they've got a lot of cavalry. Well, two units of cav. Grodzki Streltsy. Don't underestimate them. They can Zerg rush. Cossack line. Okay. So they've got over 1,000 men against me and my 360 guys. Let's make them fight for this. Yes, yes, yes. I'm also aware of that. Okay. So I should have a unit of cavalry incoming from some point. I have a feeling the enemy are going to deploy here, roughly. Let fingers crossed. Oh, damn it. They deploy first. Why doesn't it tell me where they deploy? Ooh, that's quite a hole. Didn't I get around to repairing that? Oh dear. I have a feeling the hammer blow might fall here. Okay, so infantry there. Ah, God, I don't know. So, okay, we have two sides covered. That means it will be very unlikely. Not very unlikely. There's a 50-50 chance we might be facing in the right direction. So let's to begin this.
Setting your troops to fire at will.
Wait a minute. Oh, we weren't facing in the right direction. In fact, we're on completely the wrong side of the bloody battlefield. Oh, no. We are on the right side of the battlefield. Okay. We're going to put troops here. To your stations, man. Quicker. Okay. Got cavalry on the way. Now I think my cav should be able to have a crack at their artillery. It's a big if though. Yeah, that's it. Pour in the fire. Pour it in. Oh god. Are they making for the gap? I think they are. No, they wouldn't possibly attempt a wall assault. That would be madness.
Madness. This is Sparta!
On the other hand, this is the AI of Empire Total War. Nothing is above them. Have they dismounted? Vorboim Strudzi, where are they going? Damn it, they're going back to cover their guns, aren't they? What are they doing? Alright, they're losing guys. What are you doing? Why aren't you going for the gap? Let's just see if we can flank around. We've already inflicted casualties on them. This is good. Oh dear. Thanks for climbing the wall, are you? Yeah, I don't know what you're firing at, mate. Firing at your own guys. Oh, god damn it. Take them. They're tired. My men are energized. And Russian Cav is just crap in general. So come on, guys. Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Don't let your glorious overlord down. They're flanking around. Come on, bro. Come on, come on. Yes, yes, yes. We're beating them. We're beating them. You can do it, lads. Come on. Oh, good lord. Wait a minute, what? How'd you lose the gatehouse? Oh, I see. Never mind. Or, as the Russians would say, never mind, ski. That was an awful pun. Okay, pour the fire in, pour the fire in. Pour it in, pour it in. Kill the bastards. Alright, alright. They're routing, they're routing. Get after those guns. Get after those guns. Good lord, we could actually have a chance of winning this. If they're kind enough to keep shooting at our men there. Oh damn, they're just losing guys by the bucket load. Oh, now he goes for the gap down there. Okay, that isn't good at all. Goes if my brosiths. Crap baskets. Oh well, at least we're going to make them hurt. Wipe out their artillery in its entirety, then take those dragoons. So go back down. Great. They're losing guys. How many hundreds of men have they lost? Alright. Go. 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 Give them a volley. I don't care. Volley the buggers until they're gone. Oh dear. It's never a good thing. Okay, come on, come on, come on. Open fire, you idiots. Oh yeah, blast them. Point blank. Come on. Shoo! Twenty guys just scythed down. Alright, okay, when it gets like a minute, we gotta charge back. Let's get him. Okay, our guys are losing, and they're losing rapidly. Where's he going? I think he's gonna run all the way around. He's going to try and surprise me from the front. Goodness. Oh my god. No, 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 no. Okay. Get back into position. Take out those dragoons. See if you can blast them point blank. It's her arm. Shoot! Waste, man. Okay, are they coming back around? They are. Reform. Hold fast, gentlemen. Hold fast. Oh, for goodness sakes, you are mounted on horses, you weaklings. The enemy flees. Back off at full haste. Okay. Give fire. At the devil. Let's go. Alright. This battle might have just gone in our favor. Where'd they go? I think they're routing, so I think the Electron can get a good few rounds in on them. Thank you for standing still and letting me shoot you guys. It's really helpful. Alright. Go after these guys. You might be down to almost half strength, but even if they win this by some miracle, it's still quite a costly... This is a costly defeat. Or if they lose, that would be absolutely hilarious. Where's he going? And they're just getting slaughtered. Okay. Everyone we kill is another one we don't have to deal with. Alright. They're losing guys. Let's give this lot some fire. Alright. They're losing... I think that regiment is practically broken. Don't know what these guys are doing. They've lost nearly 50 men. Okay, reform the line. This is getting a little tiresome. See if we can rout these guys. Come on, they've just got muskets and all that, so they shouldn't be too difficult. Charge A. Or whatever the Swedes say for charge. Actually, there's a question I posed to you. There was a very good, nice person who commented informing me what a Swedish agent was saying in one of my earlier videos, and I learned a little bit of Swedish. Apparently the guy is saying at last place of civilization and learning, or something along the lines of that. And this pleases me. Right. Take your revenge. Kill them all. Oh, just the Cossacks left. They've actually somehow managed to make what should have been a really close battle into a bloodbath. But hey, who am I to complain? Get off. Don't give them time to rest. Readjust that line. They have... Wow, you threw this one out the window. That could have been quite a win you had on your hands. But nope, nope, yep. So towards AI at its finest. Now then, brave defenders of St. Petersburg. One last task for you. Let's rout these peasants. They doing? Hoping if I could position my men here. Where are they going? Oh my god, really? Back that way, back that way. We're actually going up those stairs. Okie dokie. See if we can put some fire in on them. At the double. Let's go, gentlemen. How are the Hip Electron doing? Well, these chaps were very useful. Gentlemen, let's go. At the double. Blast them point blank. it's not Insta-Rom. Shoot! It is done. 3 units against 8, and I did it. I am a living god. All the man had to do was Zerg rush me. It's a simple tactic and it would have worked, but he didn't. He did not use that lovely big hole in my wall, and therefore he failed and lost service about 750 men. That's how we do it the Imperial way. Lots of firepower and splitting the enemy's force. Shush, go away now. Seriously, this dude here is a complete asshat. I mean, what does he gain from wrecking all my stuff? Seriously. Okay, let's see if we can get rid of him. Come on, assassinate. No, that doesn't sound like we have a good chance of that. Alright. Garrison St. Petersburg. They'll think twice about attacking it next time. Got some... actually replenishing my artillery now. I think I can hear an aircraft outside. That's a jet engine, definitely. Ah yes, I've actually got proper roads up now. So my men can move back and forth freely. Well, freely as in... still sort of restricted as in... never mind. Actually, I think I should probably upgrade the roads here. Then we can move our troops a bit more easily. Let's build them roads. Then we should be able to get hold of him in 3 turns and wipe him out. St. Petersburg still very much in our hands. There is the tattered remnants at Vilaiki Novogrod. Petrovskia, I don't think I'm going to be taking that anytime soon. For now, I think the best I can do is bolster my troops here. Now then, I think to prepare for this guy's arrival, I will get a garrison force for Christiania underway. Gather my troops together here, and then we'll just go and march on Copenhagen. See if we can take it. And then I will have complete mastery over this bit of the Baltic. Then I just need to get rid of Petrovskia, and just like the whole northernmost bit of the map in Europe is just mine. Yeah. Okie dokie. I'm going to send some of my agents down south. See if the Ruskies are moving any more troops my way. That's always a good thing to know. Seriously, a bit of advice early in game for Sweden. Put a rake here. And yeah, you will know enemy troop movements towards St. Petersburg. A rake here, and you've basically got Russia covered. We'll deal with him sooner or later, but... actually, you know what? I've got infantry superiority to him, and I don't think he could even take Riga. So... yeah, let's go. After him. This guy, who is he again? Carl Gustav Rexnold skills. Gustavus Adolphus and all that. Brilliant general. As I think I stated before, he was fantastic. I mean, he beat the living crap out of the Holy Roman Empire. I mean, beat it so badly that even when he was killed in the Battle of Lutzow, they were still smashed. Yeah. That's how Sweden rolled back then. They were a Baltic superpower. Alright, is there anything else I can do? No, I think that is it. Oh yeah, that's it. I'll just replenish the... right, I've got to give him a name now. How do I pronounce that? Hakapelita? Yeah, I think that's about right. Okay. The Defenders of St. Petersburg. Oh, wait a minute. St. Petersburg. Iceberg. Ha! Ah, I can actually see how it's spelt now. Petersburg. No! Oh, not enough room. Bollocks. I suppose furious fuckers of the Russians won't fit, will it? Okay, Swedish Fury. Yeah, let's go with that. Swedish Fury. Done. Okay, yeah, I think that's it. Next turn. Oh, yes. Let's do this. Alright. The enemy has been foolish enough to hand me a chance to wipe them out on a plate. They basically advanced into my zone of control. I have total unit superiority. And now I'm going to destroy them. Let's have a look. Full unit of Gordaisks. Could cause trouble. I still outnumber him, and when you outnumber Grodreisks, there's not that much they can do. So the question is, where is he going? And yes, the Swedish March is playing. I don't care. Oh god, militia. I hate them. But I can't replace them with anything else at the moment. But line infantry. Oh, are they not things of monstrous beauty? Alright. So if they charge into this, they'll get the full fire of my militia, but not of my line infantry. What a pity. Because there's this bloody stupid hill in the way. Alright, okay. Do I want to move? What do I want to do? I want to make my decision quick. I'm going to do this. Run! Run, you fools! And whilst I sit pretty on my horse. Yeah, I think that's a glitch with the hat. How it, like, it's not quite right, is it? I mean, if you go away from it a bit more, you should see it. No. I think it was meant to be the, other way around, but I don't even know. Or maybe it is meant to be like that, and I'm just an idiot. At the double, let's go. Blast them point blank, lads. Flank him. He's going after my general. Okay, that way. That way. Fire at will. God, this is lagging. Where are you lot going? Hokey dokey. I said run. Alright, Alright. Shoo! 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 Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. No. Don't you dare lose to Grodreisks. If you lose to Grodreisks, I'll never forgive you. Your line infantry, smash him. He's out of it. Take him. Come on. Shoot. 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 Shoot, you dumbasses. Fire. 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 Point blank. Come on. Fire. 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 Do not stop shooting. I don't care if there's collateral damage. You will kill these people. Oh, yes, 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 yes. We've got their general, so they're breaking. They're routing. That's over 100 of them dead. And it's done. It is done. The raids are over. Now wipe these bastards out. Charge. Well, we got the general, so that unit won't come back. And now we must destroy the Grodreisks completely and utterly. Actually, no. They're exhausted. Oh, wait, they got one of them. He ran right past you, you dumbasses.
Oh, you did well. You might have lost 100 men, but you took about 100 of them with you. So, okay, yeah, you can have a rest. Actually, what is the Swedish for, like, aim fire? Oh, yeah, I think it's Sikta. Yeah, that's it, Sikta. Chase them. Chase them, you dumbasses. Do not let them reform. The raids end today. Alright, so we've already killed about basically twice as much of them as they have of us. Now even more. So yeah, this is basically for all you people who are new to Empire Total War or who played Rome Total War. This is basically our version of peasant popcorn. They are an awful unit. Although they do pretty well for some of StarCraft 2 Zerg players, because it's all about numbers and speed, which is what they do best. They're like a tidal wave of all the things which are wrong about real-time strategy. I will go for Daka Daka over Pitter Patter any day. Or even better, there's a tactic I like to call the Rome Rush. That's basically where you rush your enemy with an overwhelming force of superior quality troops. So then you win fair and square. Yeah, I think that could be enough of slaughter. No, that wasn't a close victory. And that is how we roll. Oh, you scum. You scummy, 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 scummy scumbags. Have you no honour? God damn it. So what, there's a unit of General's Cav left, even when their charge is dead. Makes sense, I suppose. I'll finish him off with a cavalry regiment from St. Petersburg. These guys, they're green. They could do with some combat experience. Let's have a look. Oh, he's going to fight. Oh, you know what? Might as well auto-resolve it. Oh, my God. Oh. Never hit the auto-resolve button. I broke my own rule. Oh, we didn't even lose any guys. How did we, what guys did we lose? We lost people from the artillery. How did that happen? Is my general an idiot? Or do your soldiers just turn into idiots for the when you auto-resolve it? Because do they stand up in a nice formation and get shot at or cut down? I don't even get it. But whatevs, raiding force dealt with. Let's just replenish and all that. I'm still taxing the locals a bit. The nobility. Rich bastards. I'm going to tax them a bit more than the lower class. Oh, people are pretty happy with me, actually. Or pretty happy with our good king, Carl the 12th. Or, of course, known to Sabaton fans as Carolus Rex. Yes, I'm going to keep doing that joke. Deal with it. Righty-ho. We will assemble at Fort Friedrichstern. Well, army is fully replenished. Right, yeah, they're happy. Public order is so much easier to handle in this game. It's really quite useful. Let's recruit another militia regiment for, you know, just to guard that for posterity. Thing is, once I take Copenhagen, I'm going to see if I can make peace with Denmark. Because they've basically lost everything from screwing with me. That tends to happen to anyone who goes to war with me. Because I am His Holy Majesty.
I don't lose wars. I simply allow my enemies to be defeated. Alright. We want to get rid of Petrovskaya. But there's a lot of units there. So what I want to do is basically make a complete force here so we can then march against them. Then when we've done that, we'll go there, we'll siege them, we'll starve them, we'll shoot them to pieces, and then we'll go home for whatever Swedish people eat at tea. That sounded really racist. I did not mean it to be racist, because I hope I'm not racist. Because, you know, yes, yes, it is funny and all that, but, well, it can be used for. So, okay, philosophy over. Okay, they're on the move. I've re-garrisoned my troops and rigor. Ooh, I can finally build some reasonable army here. Which is what I'm going to set to immediately. At a light, no, 7-unit army. I like them. I like to use them as raiding forces and for like armies to get rid of these 2-unit things which are bloody useless. I don't use them. I never use them. Okay, what's going on in Moscow? Okay. Lightly defended. But no, first, let's not get ahead of ourselves. My main strategy is to take this, Petrovskaya, and to take Copenhagen. Then, after taking Copenhagen, I'll make peace with Denmark, because they'll have to. By then, they'll have to. So, take Denmark, make peace with Sweden, which will free up my troops. I'll then put them on boats, take them over here, and then we will combine forces from the ones sent to take Petrovskaya to march down to Moscow, take it, and we'll force the Russians to make peace. Does that sound like a good plan to you chaps? I hope it does. Okay. Next turn coming up. Oh, lovely. I don't like you. Okay. Military syllabus and all that has been researched. We can now turn our attention to some more civilized things like these. And then we'll go on to like a bit of agriculture and all that. So I can, you know, feed my people. Which is exactly what North Korea needs to be doing. Because, no. They either just do not have the infrastructure to support that population, or Kim Jong-un ate all the bloody food. Which I think he did. He looks like a pig. Bloody Kim Jong-un. But anyway, how much money am I making now? Making a fair amount. Alright. My army is nearing completion. Didn't just recruit 2 units of Nark Farmland. What does that mean? Nark Farmland Regiment of Foot. Does that mean anything in Swedish? Could you let me know? Because I know nothing about Swedish, as I've stated a few times before. Did that get us back any money? That got us a couple hundred back. But soon, with these, with Petrovskaya and Copenhagen in my possession, our treasury is going to explode with wealth. Yes. You see, I'm actually going to invade other countries profitably. Unlike America. Oh, come on. Someone was going to make an America joke at some point. I mean, seriously, though. Making profit from invading another nation. It's a pretty easy thing to do in Empire. I mean, you can invade a country like, I don't know, France here. And you can make a crap ton of cash. But no, I don't know why anyone would want to invade Iraq. Okay. So, roads. Did I bother to upgrade the ones here? No, I didn't. No. Roads are the key to a great empire. I'm doing it Rome style here. Okay. Let's put these guys in Fort Frederiksten. next turn we will finally begin the siege of Copenhagen.
Actually, do we know if there's like any other ships at these ports?
No, there is not. Siege it.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Oh, okie dokie. Quickly. Alright. So far, their fleet would, that fleet coming down here, there's an army here. If I can maintain control over this stretch of water, they won't be able to get through. That depends if they move their troops there sooner or later. If I can attack Copenhagen before they get there, gotta take it on the first turn, because I don't know if I can handle, like, I don't know, 3,000 men or something. Because we saw what happened last time I got heavily outnumbered. Oh, infantry spam. Actually, I think I might be able to deal with that. But anyway, let's see what happens. I adapt to the situation. Oh dear. It's quite a fleet they've got there. What a shame. Oh, how utterly joyful. The Swedes sailed all the way over here to attack Kronstadt. And that totaled my economy. That is irritating. But fortunately, it turns out the Swedish are... Sorry, the Danish. In this game, not in real life, are just as stupid as they are brilliant. Because instead of taking their troops over here, they decided to go get back Lübeck. Actually, what monies are they producing from there? Ooh, that looks lovely. 4,000... Oh, we don't get anything out of that. Yeah, I hope that little bit there just emphasizes naval supremacy is a good thing. But it's rather annoying because I'm not sure how they can even afford that with only two territories left. Because unlike many, I do not completely devote my resources to war. I like to keep stuff open for the economy and all that. I outnumber them for once. That's a plus. And I think I could force them into battle. Yeah, let's do this. Oh, look at all that open space. Look at it all. This is going to be a bloodbath. I've got like 12 artillery pieces. I've got 12 pounders. There's going to be a bit of pounding going on here today, if you know what I mean. Really, I make an innuendo in the middle of a video. Oh. What's modern entertainment coming to? Come off. Whatevs. Okay. Can anyone tell me what 4-2 YOLO swag means? Simply put, because I don't know much about the 21st century's dialect. It confuses me. I'm very behind with the times, as you can tell. Okay, just place artillery here. And here. Oh my god, get out the way! Jesus. Why didn't I move you earlier? Okay. So, apart from all this talk of politics, poking fun at the Americans, and my general strategy, and a bit of philosophy, what do you people think of this whole new Chaos DLC rubbish? I mean, I put up a video about it and all, but I'd like to hear your opinions a bit more, because I think it's an absolute catastrophe, personally. Because is me or a game company simply not learning their lesson at the moment? I mean, I think there's like petitions and all that at the moment, but I don't know if that's gonna work. Cause, oh, you know, could we have a complete game? Is that so much to ask? A complete game?
No DLC, everything's there. I'm looking at you too, by the way. If you do any of that crap for Mass Effect Ascension, I won't be happy. And knowing you, you probably will. EA will basically crack the whip. Just like Activision got the whip out on Destiny. Or Bungie. Actually, I don't know. I've heard some interesting stuff about that, which might prove it to be that Bungie's got no one to blame but themselves. So, okay. Some various artillery support here. Lots of guns. Guns are good. Although, seriously, American gun laws are ridiculous, just to point out. You see, violence in video games is good. Violence in the real world, not so much. I mean, like, there's no respawn! Right, okie dokie. The setup is complete. Let's blast these bastards to hell. Unlimbered. Let's begin this. Okay. Get onto their mortars. Shoot. Get him. Kill him. Fire. You've positioned them at the front of your line. Oh, we've got some of them. Oh my god, look at all the men we just killed. Alright, okay. You will concentrate fire on these guys. You will concentrate fire on these guys. How many men did I lose in that first sound for? Oh god. Mortars are such an irritating unit. They really are. So god, if you just start shooting at my general, I'm not going to be happy. Seriously, get rid of them. Got something, right? God, why do they have to position themselves so close to the front? Oh dear. We're just gonna have to take that bombardment. That's really annoying. God damn it, I hate mortars. There's such a... Ugh. Alright. Keep up the pressure. Keep up that pressure. Right. Continue firing. You missed, dumbass. Okie dokie. Oh, thank you for standing still and letting me shoot at you. Okay. Okay, we're winning the artillery engagement here. Just hope we can win it quick enough. But no, seriously, if I can just rout them, then I've won the war, basically. Sweden's not Denmark. I shouldn't get those two confused. Has lost, in short. If they lose this, they've lost the war. Because when a country loses its capital city, yeah, I can get some pretty good peace terms out of that. If you're wondering why I'm not going to charge them with my cavalry, it's because that's suicide. Okay, who is he targeting? Oh look, and another one bites the dust. Alright, all artillery. Concentrate fire on him. Oh dear, they're advancing. Damn it. Fire. Okay, one artillery. Ooh. Look, they're falling like flies. We're getting in some lovely hits on them. Okay.
They're losing guys. See them? They're boxed together. Shoot them. Where the hell are they going? Poor firing. They're dropping like flies. Keep putting round shot into them. Alright, they're making an advance. Oh my god, what's with the lag? Jesus. Is this just really laggy or something? I don't even know. Perhaps my computer's not powerful enough. Yeah, that's probably it. Alright, concentrate fire behind the rear of them. Take them from the rear. Emperor style. Oh, look at them. They are retreating. I think we've got a mass rout on the go here. In the meantime, refocus your fire on this individual. I know my cavalry never really got used, hasn't really been used this battle, but there's no reason for it. Why don't you retreat? Right, they're routing. Concentrate behind. Alright, if we can just massacre their infantry really quickly, then that means we can just sweep forward with our cavalry and wipe them out. But I'm losing a few hundred men, but you know what? It's going to be worth it. Because soon, this whole nasty, bloody affair with Denmark is just going to be over. At long last. Because Denmark made a real mistake screwing with me. It's just a bad idea in general to screw with His Holy Majesty. Keep shooting them. Keep shooting, keep killing. That's all I ask of you Karelians. Because fun fact, that was what the Swedish army of the time was referred to as the Karelians. Named after good old King Karel. King Karl. Or Carolus in Latin. I mean, I didn't mention in a video before, but yeah, this guy did basically... At the age of 18, he became King of Sweden, and he beat the ever-living crap out of Russia, Poland, Denmark, and Norway. In fact, he was only beaten by Peter the Great at Poltava. So, yeah, the guy was pretty cool. Fun fact, though, he was completely wrecked by the Russian winter. Yeah, you'd have thought people would have learned by now, but anyway, yay, war's over. It is done. Alright, Denmark is mine. Right. Let's just see if we can get the Swedes to bugger off. Danish. Damn, I need to stop getting that mixed up. Alright. You're smashed. You're broken. Now piss off. I'm gonna give you money to piss off. Yep, fine, I'll pay. Laters, bye. Smashed. Now, would you accept a trade agreement? But really? Factions in this are so averse to trading, it's ridiculous. Alright, now that bloodbath is over. Okay, we should attend to rebuilding that port. Man, that's a big blow to Swedish, to Danish. Danish! Damn it, pride. Oh god. Menshikov. Alexander Menshikov.
another infantry spam army, duh. With my somewhat creepy artillery and my terrible and somewhat offensive Russian accent. Duh.
I will never do that again. I'm so sorry to any of my Russian viewers. I didn't mean to offend you. Please don't unsubscribe, please. Okie dokie. I think I'll do one more turn and then that'll be enough for today. So for now, let us pull money into... Oh my god, the amount of cash that just went. Jesus. Okie dokie. I think that'll be enough for today. Wow, Odense. Damn. You research those common land enclosures. That should help feed my people. Alright then. The final turn of this episode. What? 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 Why? What? How? What reason? What? Okay, so not everyone's an asshole. Yeah, I'll take that. Thank you. Yeah, laters. A la Mger the second. I don't understand. I do not understand. What reason does Great Britain have to go to war with me? We had a real profitable trade agreement. Everything was going great. And then they backstabbed me without any reason or purpose. And now their fleet's coming in here. So why have they done that? Oh, although that's quite a weak army. Alright. I'm not going to make peace with them just yet. I am going to hammer punch them instead. I am going to wipe out that army and one of their best generals. And then they all come crawling back to me. So alright, let's just check the road. Okay, there's that guy. And yeah, he's on his way up. I think it'll be best to keep the army in St. Petersburg for now. We'll have to march out and fight that guy sooner or later. Don't have to get onto the Potovskaya. God, so laggy. What's all this about? Okay, come on. 60 frames per second. You can do it. You've got a GTX 970, for God's sake. On the other hand, Empire Total War is a horrifically optimized game. Even if it is one of my favourites. But yes, I believe that shall be all for now. Thank you so very much for watching, and thank you for your patience over the last couple of weeks. I've just been a very, very busy man. What with being a boarding school and all that, and not quite having the energy to really do anything when I come home on the weekends. But now, during this half term, I've had the time to put this together for you. Although I think just before its end, I should be able to crank out a War Thunder episode for you, which hopefully you will like. Until then, remember to like, subscribe, and maybe even comment for the glory of the Empire.